Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. Today's topic is problems of reincarnation. Let me play a clip of 1995 American movie Before Sunrise.
All right, I had a thought the other day that was kind of qualifies as a problem.
What is it?
Well, it was a thought I had on the train. So, okay, all right. Do you believe in reincarnation?
Yeah, right. It's interesting.
Well, most people, you know, a lot of people talk about past lives and things like that, you know, and even if they don't believe it in some specific way, you know, people have some kind of notion of an eternal soul, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, this was my thought. 50,000 years ago, there are not even a million people on the planet. 10,000 years ago, there's like 2 million people on the planet. Now, there's between 5 and 6 billion people on the planet, right? Now, if we all have our own, like, individual, unique soul, right, where do they all come from? You know, are modern souls only a fraction of the original souls? Because if they are, that represents a 5,000-to-1 split of each soul in just the last 50,000 years, which is like a blip in the Earth's time. You know, so at best, we're like these tiny fractions of people, you know, walking. I mean, is that why we're all so scattered? You know, is that why we're all so specialized?
Wait a minute, I'm not sure. I don't agree.
I know. It's a totally scattered thought. Which is kind of why it makes sense.
Yeah. You know? I agree with you.
Yeah. Let's get off this damn train.
This supposed problem of reincarnation has an easy answer. Number one, is Earth the only planet with life? The question starts with the assumption that there is life only on Earth. Hindu scriptures such as Yoga Vashishta, Tripura Rahasya, talks of infinite creation and planets with life all around us. Even if the creation isn't infinite, modern science as of today estimates that there are 10 to the power of 24 stars in the observable universe. Observable universe could be a minuscule compared to the real scale of universe. Why are we assuming there is life only on Earth? It is quite possible that we are born in one planet in this life and in another in the next. This explains why there can be more life on planet Earth now than before. Number 2. Spiritual evolution. Karma and reincarnation concepts explain that reincarnation is a process of evolution of the jiva. Life starts in something as basic as a rock and then it gradually evolves through different bodies such as insects, birds, animals, humans, by its own intention to experience more of life. This evolution explains why there can be more humans now on Earth than before. Number 3. Non-physical universe. The science can only study what is physical. The scriptures talk of existence in layers that are beyond physical. If that is a possibility, if the existence is not just physical, then that too explains why there are more humans living now on Earth than before. Thank you for watching this video. If you like our videos, please do like, comment, and subscribe.